For what father would make it up? What father would conjure a story about his daughter, willingly separating her twin children for any reason other than the truth? The only question left is whether he really has found everything he's been searching for all along. There's a whisper in Johnny's ear now, an echo from the past. What had his mother said to him the night before she never woke up? Even though she whispered it in Hebrew, he's sure she told him he would find a piece of himself here if he ever came back to look. Is this what she meant? How could she possibly have known? Finally, Johnny sees them for what they are. All the images he'd conjured for himself of Beit Leora playing through his mind, these fanciful imaginings of the place where he might find himself, where he might finally understand, where, in actual fact, he's found himself on top of the most twisted truth of all, and it's only happened by accident, and where, in actual fact, his long-lost grandfather has become so desperate he has tricked himself into the most deluded conclusion of all. The girl cowering on the floor before Johnny comes slowly back into focus. As obviously unrelated to him as it is obvious, too, that somewhere out there, who the hell knows where, is another girl who is. Another girl who Johnny is now going to spend the rest of his life searching for, too. But before he can ask his last and final question, the door opens into a collective gasp, a wiry shadow falling into the room. Johnny's heart kicks at his chest, for the next words he hears arrive in a language that he will forever understand. Chapter 45. Tom steps forward, hands out.